What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode on my YouTube channel. My name is Sarah Wild. I'm a SRNA, short for Certified Registered Nurse Anesthetist. I put you to sleep for surgery.
So. I want to drive you wild, wild, wild. I want to love you for miles and miles.
I am going to do a series on all things anesthesia school. I don't want to do like one long video, so I'm going to try to break it up into segments and kind of do different topics. So today, I just want to talk about like pre-anesthesia school, what it even looks like, if you're kind of like thinking about nursing in nursing school, pre even applying to anesthesia school, this is more for you. So I just couple quick questions I've had multiple times regarding anesthesia school. So first, what does it take to get into CRNA school? I remember I was in nursing school when I first decided I wanted to pursue anesthesia school, and I had no idea really what a CRNA, all they did and what it looked like and what was school like. So just some things that you're going to even need before you can even apply to anesthesia school is your bachelor's degree. Some people, you can do like a bachelor's of science and get an accelerated nursing degree on top of that, or you can just do a bachelor's of nursing. Each anesthesia program is going to have different requirements as far as like physics and all that stuff. So later on, you can kind of look at their programs and see what's required. But most nursing programs will have everything you need. You're going to need 1 to 2 years of ICU experience. Most programs, it's 2 years. Some programs will get you by with 1 year. I would suggest if you're sure you want to do anesthesia school, go straight into the ICU out of nursing school. Now, not every ICU is going to have this opportunity. Usually it's like the bigger learning hospitals where you can do kind of like a training program as a new nurse, because ICU obviously is higher level nursing care. But that would be my suggestion, especially if you want to get there faster. That'll give you all the experience you need to get into school. Like, I know some CRNAs that like, you need 10 years of experience as a nurse. I don't agree with that. You really just need your basic skills to learn, just to get comfortable with needles, syringes, patient care and such. All of your knowledge and education is going to come from anesthesia school. Next, you're going to need a decent GPA. So I encourage you, while in nursing school, take the time, do well. You know, I think most programs require at least a GPA of 3.0. But like, they look at all this when they determine if they're gonna even give you an interview or not. So get your GPA higher. The higher you can get it, the more competitive you'll be to even get an interview. I wanna say my program, I think there were over 500 applicants and only 150 got interviews and only 70 got accepted. So it's definitely competitive. And the other thing too, so focus on that, finish nursing school, get into an ICU, and then once you get into the ICU and you get settled in your job, start studying for your GRE and get signed up for the GRE. You can take it multiple times. The GRE is kind of one of those really annoying tests where it encompasses everything that you really just don't have any desire to study for. Vocabulary. I remember sitting in the ICU like with my vocabulary note cards. I'm like, when am I ever going to use this word? But you know, the GRE score is super important to be competitive. So start doing that. And then honestly, like from my own personal experience, I was not a 4.0 student in nursing school. I didn't have the highest GRE score. I would say I was like average. I was pretty decent, but not like, whoa, mind blowing. For me, my letter to my application, like why I chose me, I spent so much time because my goal was to make myself stand out, you know, and things they want to hear are you're dedicated, you're hardworking, you know, you have a work ethic, like, you know, you have a really good work ethic and, you know, they just want to hear the qualities that they know at the end of the day, they want someone who they know is going to make through their program, because I hate to say it, they want to provide good CRNAs. They want their name to look good and they don't want to lose money on you. because it's all about the relationship with the clinical sites and how well their school saves face and looks. So that letter, make yourself look good. You know, it's kind of a weird place to get in starting to talk about yourself. Now, obviously, don't BS. Don't say you're good at something you're not. But find ways to talk about your strengths in a humble way. It's interesting. I learned a lot through the application process, through the interview process. I was so nervous for my interview, but I will say that's one thing I felt was a strength of mine was interviewing. I felt like if I could just get to that interview, and it was awesome. It was very intimidating. I think I had like a panel of 5 people sitting there just grilling me, and they would ask me questions like, what are your strengths? And then what are your weaknesses? And like, you have to answer your weaknesses in a way that your weaknesses are strengths. It's kind of a mind game, but anyways. Okay, so next, what to expect with anesthesia school. So first of all, I think a lot of the programs are switching over to DNP programs. I know my program is. A lot of times, at least with my program, that first year is a lot of just online DNP work, and you can still work part-time, but once your program actually starts, that first year full-time, that is like the make it or break it year. I want to say my program had 30% attrition rate. So that means out of the 70 some students we had, 30% failed. That is a lot. Now I will say my program is a little old school, cutthroat, not super forgiving. Hopefully not all programs are like that, but anesthesia school is hard. You know, you have to, you really have to put in the time. So expect that first year to like have no life. You know, depending on your program, if it's front loaded or integrated, you're going to be doing studying full time, and they're like high level classes, you know, pharmacology, physiology, 1, 2, and 3. They're not like A&P. A&P is so ridiculously easy compared to the programs you will do in anesthesia school. So I study a lot. I just read constantly. And then you're in clinicals full-time, or at least we were. I think maybe with the DNP programs, they spread it out a little bit, but you're still in the clinicals, and clinicals are terrifying because you don't know anything. Everyone's grilling you, you know, like, what's the efficacy of propofol? They ask you all these things that I don't think I could answer off the top of my head. Like, I know the generalized answer, but I don't know, like, 3 to 5 minutes or, you know, like the very textbook answer. And like, you get grilled on that crap, and it's stressful. I literally had like a traveling rash on my body. Like, one day I'd wake up and my lips would be swollen. The other day I'd wake up and I'd had hives all over my body. I literally got a stomach ulcer just from the stress. And I'm like such like a chill person. Like, I don't get stressed. And I was stressed. I was like, ugh. So make sure going into it, you realize you're gonna kind of be putting your life on hold. Tell your family, I love you, I'll see you in 3 years. Tell your friends, I love you, I maybe can hang out once a month, maybe, you know. And that first year is gonna be really hard. Second year gets a little bit better, but you're still super busy. No, like, no vacations. Now I will say there are some programs that you get some good time off. I never did. I got 5 days off of clinicals a semester, which there's 3 semesters in a year, trimesters. But I got no like vacation time. So we would do like little weekend getaways, but I would literally be sleeping or studying the whole time. Okay, the next thing is, how do you plan? How do you plan to do well in anesthesia school? So I would say create realistic expectations. Like I said, you're constantly studying. So I had a planner. I would write out my days, you know, Sunday through Saturday, and I would schedule, okay, sleep. I would write down how long I was allowed to sleep. I would write how long I had for breakfast. I would write down how long I would study for each subject. I would write down my breaks. I would write down my time with my husband. I allotted every minute that first year. And I was super organized because you have so much to do. You have so much to study. You can get lost and you can really get behind in certain things. So I stuck to that schedule and I made school my life. Like, every once in a while I got to do things. Like, I love to have fun. I love to go do things. And there was none of that, you know, like, anesthesia school was my life. So, and I will say another tip, just how to plan to do well, find healthy outlets, but they have to be short outlets. Like, your outlet can't be playing golf every day. It's got to be, you know, 30 minutes or so of go to the gym, take a nap, go running. I don't know what it is, but find like a healthy outlet to give yourself just like a 30 minute break, refresh, because you're going to be using that a lot. And then I would say, determine what your support system is and really lean on your support system. So mine was my husband. And like, I remember one of the questions they asked me, they're like, in my interview, you're married, do you have a good relationship? Is your husband willing to lose you for the next 2 years because you will not be around? And it was so true. Like, I literally scheduled him in 3 hours once a week. That's all I saw him. I was lucky if I had dinners with him. I usually just ate something on the go in the library. So change your expectations. I felt like some of the people that failed out weren't able to adjust their home life. And, you know, whether or not they had kids or what it was just too much for them to manage. Another thing I would encourage is don't plan on any major life changes while you're in school. You know, so I planned this. I got pregnant in my last year on purpose, thinking, okay, I'll have like some time after, you know, I'll graduate, have my baby, have my maternity leave, and then start my job. Well, it was just, it was stressful. It was hard on my body. And even though I planned it, I'm so thankful, like, it turned out okay. Life is going to be so much easier if you don't plan any major. So don't get married, don't break up if possible. But yeah, try to keep your other personal life stress down to a minimum. And I would just say overall, structure is key. Okay, structure is key. So as you're thinking about anesthesia school, things to look for. When I started researching what school I wanted to go to, things I looked for. What is their board pass rate? That was super, super important to me. I wanted to be able to take my boards and do well. What is their attrition rate? You know, like, okay, you can get into school, but are you going to get kicked out so easily? Are they going to be advocates for you? What are your clinical rotations like? Do they have access to good hospitals? A big important one for me was regional. Am I going to be able to do regional anesthesia in school? And then you can start looking into like the requirements and stuff like that. But at the end of the day, you're going to have to sacrifice and be willing to do that. So as you're thinking about this and you're thinking about jumping into this, I want you just to take a second and ask yourself a couple questions. First, why do you want to go to anesthesia school? Why do you want to be a CRNA? And having said that, if you have a good answer, then follow that with, are you willing to put your life on hold and sacrifice friends and family and your lifestyle for the next 3 years? Because it's going to be long and it's going to be challenging and it's going to be grueling. And it will be worth it, but you have to put in the time. So those are just a couple thoughts for me. I absolutely love my job. I love my home life. I love the lifestyle this job affords me, but it was a lot of work. So make sure you're ready and don't invest in something that's gonna fail. So good luck, guys. If you have any questions, comment below. Don't forget to like this, follow me, and subscribe for more anesthesia content. So. I wanna drive you wild.